हेलो एवरीवन, सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट यूजीसी नेट एग्ज़ाम और दी एनटीए नेट एग्ज़ाम व्हिच इज़ गोइंग टू बी हैपनिंग इन द मंथ ऑफ अक्टूबर, राइट? सो वी ऑल हैव सीन नोटिफिकेशन एंड दोज हु हैव येट टू नो, दोज हु डोंट हैव एनी आइडिया, लेट मी जस्ट रिमाइंड यू दैट यूजीसी, दैट एनटीए नेशनल टेस्टिंग एजेंसी हैज़ published the new mode or the date for the new NET exam. They're going to merge the two exams, which is December 2020 and June 21, and there's a bit complication. We are like some people are in like a different kind of stage because they don't have time to study for both the exams. Will these exams be conducted together or separately? I still don't know. I don't know. I am like you also. So in this class or a discussion, I'm going to talk about how to face the NTA UGC NECT exam. It's for beginners. It can be like maybe a person who's an experienced person who is better than me can even say this. So I'm talking this, I'm presenting this as a point, like as a person who has been like who has generally seen the NET exam, and I'm just sharing my views. And let's just go to a topic right now. So how to face the NTA NET exam, which is Tourism Administration and Management. First of all, let me remind you that NTA, that getting cleared, getting like to clear the NET exam is a big time taking process. Some might think that having a zero negative mark and just going without any preparation, you will get like success rate, and you might also have experiences that your friends without any preparation has got the like assistant professorship, but nobody in this entire world or India has never cleared NET exam without any single preparation. You need to do something. You need to like prepare, or you need to do something, right? So for the beginners and for the people, let me just show you how to clear this exam. And once again, I'm just trying myself. This is not the entire solution. I cleared the NTA NET exam. It was in July 2018. That was the last exam that was conducted by CBSE. Right now it's NTA, right? So I have written in 2014. That was in written exam. I have never attended the online exam, and I am like you going to attend this exam this year, right? And regarding my experiences online exams, from 20 like 2007, I have been writing the entire online exams in terms of bank, SSC, PSC, any single exam. I have that experience in me. So I have written exams that contained 45 minutes to 3 hours, net, set, everything, and I have failed in all of them. I have failed in every exams. And getting failure in each exams made me want to go ahead, but I still didn't get my success. And the only exam that I ever cleared in my entire life is the NET exam. So right now I'm currently working as an assistant professor, or because of I have an NET exam, that too in assistant professorship. I have never cleared JRF. It's a very tough process for me. So let me try to share my experience, and let me, for the students who are beginners and for the people, I am trying to give a general idea. Once again, let us go into a topic. Right now, I have written one thing is called cut off the 100%. Never in your dreams, and don't try to look in the cut off. If you are going to like study for an NTA NET, never try to study only for cut off. Like you are taking that from paper 1 and paper 2, you are trying that, okay, in paper 1 I'll get 60 marks, or 60 questions I'll score 60, and in paper 2 I get 100, and total I get 160, then 54, 53. Don't try looking at it. If you are in any type of classification, general or any other category, please don't try to look into it. Go for 100%. Because in NET exam, that too in tourism industry management, question will come in anywhere. And you have to study for anything under the sun. But that doesn't mean you don't have any hope. You have hope. Like, so right now, let me try to simplify the process by telling that every single exam that has occurred in terms of UGC NET, Travel and Tourism Management has a pattern. And that pattern can be easily be understood. For the people who are going to prepare to face this exam for the first time, and for the people who are experienced and who have scored more and more, they actually know it. Try to go for previous year question paper. That's the model of every UPSC students. And I have also written for UPSC, and in that place I got the power, I got the entire area, like they try to like the students and the teachers try to tell me never go for blank reading. That's like you reading so many books, like completely reading everything will not be coming into that 200 question, that is paper 2, right? So you have to do smart work. You have to do hard work and smart work. Number one you have to do is that in every question paper, you will get these four areas apart from comprehension. Number one, StatGK. In terms of StatGK, the most major topics that comes are called like Dance Forms of India, Art Forms of India, IATA Code, and Food of India, Delicacies of India, which is match the following. For example, Mishti Doi, Payasam, and Pongal. And in the left corner, you will get delicacies. In the right corner, you will get the states of India. Or IATA codes, which is either international or domestic. For example, having Andaman Nicobar, which is IXZ, etc. Is there, no? Like that. Or the international codes and the countries. So static GK are set of things that will definitely come. It has occurred. So one thing you have to do is to go through previous year question paper, like try to go through a 10 question paper minimum. Right now, if you are like seeing this video, I'm requesting you, for the beginners, try to go for the previous year question paper. And if you want to see the previous year question paper, I had already made a video regarding it. That too, that was in PowerPoint presentation, 50 minutes long. In that, I have like tagged some PDF areas, study material for you to study for like net freely, right? So right now, first go for previous year question paper. In previous year question paper, you will get the idea that there are certain questions that frequently be occurring, which is coming under StatGK. StatGK comes like it actually tells about the terms that will never be like changing. For example, like taglines of tourism, taglines of different states, the cuisines, the hospitality management terms, or the rivers of India, wildlife sanctuaries, biosphere reserves, or the tourism circuits. Those things which never be changing. It will never change. It is a part of our history, right? So the UNESCO World Heritage Sites and the entire chain hotels in India. These are some questions that usually occurring over these years. If you look at the previous year question paper from what 2000 to 2020, if you look at the 20 years question paper, you will get the idea that these questions usually occur. Then comes concept, which is happening, which is the entire thing that is, we'll be talking about tourism, visitor, execute, like excursionist, who is a visitor, who is an excursionist, like that. So these are questions that consist of concepts, like for example, and models also. I have written models, I think it is in the next section. Right, so concept that clearly consists of terms and conditions that consists of textbook. If you have textbook, like if you have books, try to go for it. And if you don't have any materials, I request you to go to Google and just type tourism CBSE. There are free materials which is provided by the government to the tourism students. You can study the entire thing there. And next is research management models and theories. These are certain, it looks like the same area, like these two have same kind of a connection, like these topics will never change, they will usually be occurring there. Research, which consists of type of research, research models, research procedure, those topics consist of tourism statistics, like the poison distribution, skewed curve, like that, no? And models, which is the tourism models, Butler's life cycle model, then the IRIDEX model. These models will generally be occurring in every single exams in terms of an objective question or the match the following. Motivation, theories of motivation also comes under like that. And next, at the last score, current affairs. Current affairs means these contain topics or news that is associated with tourism. For example, the last legislative, if you have seen that UNESCO has added two heritage sites. One, that's Dholavira, which is Harappa, and two, Ramappa temple, that in Telangana, right? So these two are added into UNESCO World Heritage Site. You might be getting that question in this year's December or June NET exam. These are called current affairs. If your exam is in October, try to collect events that are consisting, that is related to tourism, till the month of, if it is October, let me go back to September, and August, right, August or September, till August, you need to collect the data till August, because the question paper or the model will be taken 2 months prior, and before the entire date, right? So they will be fixing the question paper minimum 1 month before the entire date of the exam, if it is happening in October, right? So current affairs means all the changes, all the new additions, tourism minister, tourism slogans, new hotels, and the vaccine passport. You have seen vaccine passport that is usually seen in the news. So all those terms and conditions that are associated with tourism, aviation, hospitality comes under current affairs. So these four areas are mostly occurring in every single tourism paper over this few years, I think. So to face this NTA NET exam, let me remind you one thing. Study, but don't study. I'm talking to those people who want to study, who have jobs, who like to study, but who could not sit in one bench or chair, or who could not be steady, who don't have that willpower, or who want to do it but could not be they could not study due to various reasons. For them, I'll tell you that for NTA NET Tourism Administration Management exam, try to prepare, but don't do the traditional way. Try to distract your mind, try to trick your mind by telling you that you are not studying. For that, you need to do smart work, which is going into YouTube channels, trying to find out, preparing your own notes. For me, I'm not a major scholar person. I want to study. I started to study after when I went to civil service. I have done coaching for civil service. At that time only, at that time I was 25 years old, I think. At the age of 25, I started studying. Till that time, I was a backbencher. I failed in every subject. I was an altogether, what we say, a below average student that the old society used to denote me. But right now, what I do is that when I prepare, I try to make it more colorful. I use sketch pens, like a small five-year boy or girl. I try to use sketch pens. I try to make my notes. I try to simplify it because I like to study now. But in the best part about Tourism NET administration and management is that these topics are generally it's not actually a tough topic. It's actually related to our daily life now. So when we study it, we can use it for more other exams also. For the students who are preparing for a PSC or UPSC, they can also use this exam as a part of to excel themselves. I'm sorry, my speech and my thing are not getting up to mark, I think. I'm sorry for my language or vocabulary. If it is wrong, please bear with me. So to pass to, I'm trying to how to face the exam, not to clear the exam, because never try to think that you need to clear this exam. You need to clear this exam, but you need to give your 100%. So when you're facing it, you have to face it with pride and courage. I know lots of people watching this video have cleared, have lost it in 1 mark and 2 mark, who has that frustration. There may be people who are disliking for this video because I am saying stupid things. But as a person, personally, I want to do this video because for right now, we are having in that pressure situation, that pandemic era, everything. But having such thing, everything also, like we have everything. But apart from that, we are like taking our time for preparing ourselves, right? For the students, for the beginners, try to use books, try to prepare yourself, try to make notes for yourself, try to make learning like enjoyable. Don't try to depend on books, that to textbooks, or don't try to go for the entire basic textbooks. I'm talking to the people who are studying for the first time and who could not study, like they want to sit, but if they turn their books, they will be sleeping. For them, for not the hardworking people, they are hardworking people, they are dedicated, please follow like that. For the people who want to study but could not get time, or like they don't like to depend on one book, try to use the internet, try to find new free resources. I'll do one thing, I'll share some data I have, I'll share it in description box if I have it, and I try to upload it in this description box if it is necessary. So I'm ending this small video, it's a discussion, not a video. Try to face it for the first paper, for the first person who are trying to applying, who are trying to facing this exam for the first time, please go for it. Give your 100%. First, try to know your entire enemy. Like examination is your competition. You are starting a war. You need to find your enemy. You need to find your opposition, right? You just find it. Go for studying that. Before that, go for previous year question paper. This is an unedited video. You'll be getting lots of mistakes in the video. I'm sorry for it. I want to talk to you like this regarding, so please comment below regarding exams or experience, etc. Please comment below. And if this video is helpful for you or are not helpful for you, please dislike it, comment it, do anything, please respond. So best of luck for the people who are studying for the exams. Best of luck for everyone who is facing the exam. You will get 100%. Your cutoff is 100. You go for 100, you will get your cutoff, right? And I hope all of you have understood my what I was trying to say. Please face your exams. Don't think about failure or success. Just face it. Give your 100%. Try to make notes. Try to learn what is ahead of you. And I hope most of you will get success this next exam. So thank you. And that's all, I think. Thank you.